selected. He returned to Moscow and stayed with relatives and friends from his village. He went to his friends to help him. He went to his friends to help him find a job. It was becoming more and more irksome every minute for him to trample the streets in idleness. He left no stone unturned in his efforts to achieve some kind of job. He tried all his friends and acquaintances, even stopped people in the street and asked if they knew about a job anywhere, but in vain. Gerasim finally reached to the door of his friend Yegor Danilich, who worked at a barn. This man managed a job that brought about the climax of this story. What happened? In order to secure a place for Gerasim, Yegor, the coachman, poisoned the ales of his master against an old employee. The master knew that the old man had all the merits of a good worker. Yet he could not help falling to the eloquence of his coachman, and he decided to take Gerasim at the old man's place. Gerasim was now very happy to have finally a job for himself, right? Now, Polycorpych was the old servant of the house, getting to be fired in order for Gerasim to get the job. He and his wife were in deep trouble to get out of the work at the fake end of their life. The old couple wept and mourned for losing their only source of living to the coachman's friend. By the way, this building, the people, you can see the time of this Gerasim is wandering on the streets. This is actually the city of Moscow, right? So, Polycorpych's wife called Yegor the devil and said that he was horrible because he stole food from his boss, like hay and fodder. This was overheard by Gerasim, and it stabbed him like a dagger. He was a kind of a guy who never constructed his dreams by shattering others' life. At the end, we observed that Yegor ends up not being the star employee. Okay, he's bossy, he likes to get people in trouble and get people to do his work for him. And the anticlimax of the story is reached when the young man, Gerasim, who we are talking about, did choose to be workless rather than to steal the old man's position. He got the job, but did not take it. He realized what misfortune he would be bringing the old people. So he refused the job and left the place. Okay, dear students, finally let's go and try to compare and contrast the two characters. One is angelic and another is devilish. So let us see. Gerasim and Yegor, the coachman, are the two faces of the same coin. Why? As they come from the same village, but with different nature, attitude and caliber. Okay. Yegor, the coachman, was working under a merchant known as Sheikh, who was wealthy, while Gerasim was working as a servant for some other merchant, right? Meanwhile, he was summoned to his village for military duty, but unfortunately, he was not selected for it. When he again approached his old employer, he refused to take him back, as the place was already filled. He was then jobless. In this regard, he wandered place to place in search of a job, but could find nothing. Gerasim was an honest and humble fellow and was very sincere, but his coachman was clever, But the coachman was clever, proud and dishonest. Gerasim was simple, kind-hearted and loving, while as the coachman was cruel, cunning and stone-hearted. Gerasim was self-sacrificing and straightforward, who gave up the job when he needed it desperately, while as the coachman was selfish and had a glib tongue, who knew how to wag it. Gerasim did not want to be praised, but the coachman was only happy to hear sweet words about his personality, though he managed to get Gerasim employed in the old servant's place by telling so many lies against the old couple. But when Gerasim heard the painful story of the couple, it made him sick at heart, and being humble and sympathetic, he refused to take the work. Okay? So, dear students, this was about the compare and contrast of characters. Let's go to the most important area. That is the theme of the story. And let me tell you, stories are to be taught only with the intention that the messages present in them reach to the learners implicitly. It is expected that the constructive life skills that are conveyed through the stories bring up the learners with all-round development to be the successful citizens of tomorrow. The citizens should identify themselves with the thoughts of the characters in a story and evaluate their choices and preferences with reference to the protagonists, I mean the main characters, the heroes in the stories, right? So in this story, we have the story has a powerful message, theme of sympathy, sacrifice, empathy, and feeling the pain, problems of others in need. Okay, in the case of Gerasim, as we can see, he is truly an angel in his deeds as against the selfish, cruel, callous, mean character of Yegor, who with his lies, cheating and glib tongue gets undue favors from people in trouble and behaves like a devil. So we leave it to the students to see who they love the most between the two characters, right? So let me come down to some questions. If you have understood the story, you'll be able to understand the questions. So the question number one is, there are some words and I ask you to make some sentences on each of the words. For example, almshouse, house for the poor, allurements, strong attractions, compulsion, and influence or urge, of our own accord, without assistance by ourselves. Serpent, a sly or dangerous person, like a snake. Fodder, food for horses or cattle. So try to make sentences on these very words. Very important, this will help you to understand the story. Then another very important question that I discussed throughout the notes in the PowerPoint presentation. And the question is like this: compare and contrast the characters of Gerasim and Yegor. So you can, I hope you will do it easily. Now you can draw this character, right? Try to do it. And last one, this will leave you thinking and try to think it over, right? For example, if you were in the Gerasim's shoes, if you were Gerasim, you were hungry, you were homeless, you had no job, okay? And you get a job after somebody is removed from the job, and you get a job like Gerasim, how would you feel after getting the work? Agar aapko milta hai, to aap kaise feel karoge, right? So try to answer this question, okay? So thank you very much.